a lot of companies, a lot of entrepreneurs are struggling right now about their planning moving forward because of the pandemic. No one was ready for this one. No one expected that one too. But overall, in every 10 years, there is a catastrophe happened in the economy. If you look back, every 10 years, there is a catastrophe. The last one in 2000, in 2008, and this one is a little bit late, 2020. But anyway, the catastrophe is already here. So about this one, I want to hear about your experience being a CEO, working and other corporations from many years of time. So the companies who are facing for the challenge due to NCOV19, what will be your 5 tips for them to handle this situation? What they should do right now?
Okay, I think this part is really hard, and I even myself actually experienced a lot, and I can feel it. It's a tough, I can say, the most difficult one in the life that we have to face, and you face it very inactive way. That means you're not really proactive to do anything. You just sit there and just wait to see how it's going. You cannot do anything. You cannot plan anything. So that's the worst of the part. All right. From 2020 until now, I think about 2 years, right? Early of 2020, right? Until now is about 2 years something. By end of 2024 is about 2 years. I actually did a lot of things also during this period. Although at the beginning, I actually get shocked, okay? Get shocked because I never imagined, and I also told to my one of my colleagues that they can say the worst value of my life, he actually this time, because I cannot forecast that COVID happened. If I can forecast, because my life is doing a lot of forecast, but this time I cannot forecast, okay? And I actually failed. This is a big fail of my life. So, but after that, after very disappointed, very stressful, I try to think positive. That's the first thing that I give a suggestion for the young people. This is the time that you need to be positive. Positive will help you to get over this hard period. Positive will help you to think something actually better for the situation. So the first thing is when I can get the positiveness with myself, then I did one of the good things I did for during the COVID time is a community work, a community job. I bring my knowledge, okay? I share my knowledge, my expertise to the community for free, without any charge. So that means I create a channel, okay? And then I publish on my knowledge, my experience about revenue management. I give it to the community who want to learn, who want to improve, and especially for this time, you know, people have time, okay? The COVID, it actually make a lot of worse thing, but that make a good thing is people having time. Because when you have time, you can do a lot of good thing, actually, right? For example, you can learn. People actually spend a lot of time now to learn new thing, to learn something that they want, but they cannot make it before. So this is a time that we can share something valuable for them to learn. So for me, like I created a Vietnam Hospitality Hub. It's a hub that I bring on the good professional one, expert in the industry. And then we together share our knowledge, our experience via the webinar. So that, you know, everybody in the community, in the hospitality and travel community, they can join the event. They can learn something that they never can learn it from the school, or maybe they never know that before in their working experience. So that's why when I did that community work, there's a lot of viral on that. People really love it. And now is the community is bigger and bigger now. People are joining, and then the student joining, universe joining, even the lecturer from the university, they also join the community to learn the experience, to learn the practice, the best practice in the industry, so that they can share with the student. Yeah, so that's the second thing that you can do during the time of COVID, when you have time, free time a lot, right? You need to do something valuable for your time. Then find something that can generate the cash flow for you. Like me, let's say Bedlinker, we do a lot of inbound business, right? We bring the foreign traveler come to Vietnam. But when the COVID time, the border is closed, no inbound guests come. Then no business. You cannot do anything, right? No business at all. And even the domestic market also closed, then travel closed. Everything, like the business completely closed. You cannot do anything for travel. Then at that time, I do the consultancy for revenue management. I do the training. I do the coaching. I do the mentoring. For those who would like to learn and to apply the revenue management into their business, into their practice. All right. So that's what I did. So at least we can do something meaningful, but also generate cash for you, so that at least you need to survive. Survive is something that you need to find this way or another way to survive. So as a leader, you have to find a way. There's no excuse for that. Okay. Focus on, still focus on those important of your goal, of your life, your goal in life. Because think about when you start your startup, right? During this time, I always think about what I thought during the time that I created Bedlinker, the time that I start up Bedlinker, what I want to achieve, what is the goal that I want to achieve. I still want to stay with that, all right? I still want to focus and stay with that goal, although now it's interrupted by COVID, okay? But I need to still focus on the goal that you think this is the goal of your life. You need to still stay focused on that and waiting for the opportunity back. And I still believe that it's going to be back sooner or later. It's just time. All right. So still be positive and believe in it. And then focus on that. Don't lose your attention or lose your direction because of this. All right. But okay, the last one, I think, even though you think that, okay, this is a good one for you to focus on the goal that you set before, but this is a time for you also to think something new, okay? New opportunity, because COVID, it actually changed a huge things in this market. It changed a lot of things. So maybe there's some business model or some goal that you set before is not appropriate anymore. All right, so you need to maybe find something new that can apply now and maybe after the COVID time. So this is a time that you have time to think about that. So this is what I actually did for the last 2 years until now. And I think that make me happy. At least I cannot, like, even the business is going down, have nothing to do with business, but I still find that I have time to engage with the community. I have time to engage with the industry, still networking with the people in the industry, keep relationship with them, give them something valuable that can create an opportunity for you in the future. All right, at least these are the things that I think I did good for the last, can say 2 years with COVID time. Yeah.
Thank you. Viewers, this is the thing, 5 tips for you. Number one, accept and be positive. Number two, give back during this time. Number three, you have time, so use it to produce new product or improve your product. Number four, focus on something which can generate cash flow for you, because at the end of the day, you still need something cash. Number five, reflect and reorganize your plans and goals. And this, you have time, right? So again, just that's really number three, is about you can reflect and reorganize your plans too. It's probably this is a time for you to pivot as well too. What you wanted to do before, maybe you could do different thing right now. And that's why reflecting, it should be starting from reflecting rather than you decide something and then you could do reflection. That will not do. You could do in both way, but I think you should think about from start with reflection.